So hello everyone. I've been working on a game for the entirety of November for a game of 2023 with a very vague theme of scale. Unlike my previous gems, I decided to choose the obvious idea instead of overcomplicating it. So I went with the idea of scaling a mountain, as I wanted to keep the scope small and polish it as much as possible instead. This idea by itself wouldn't be enough for a good theme score, so I decided to give the player the ability to change sizes and some mechanics based on those. By the end of the first week, I finished most of the movement system. In this video, I want to show you a bunch of cool things that made the different mechanics really easy and smooth to use. I don't really want to talk about the basic movement stuff that much, as it's not really that interesting, but if anyone wants to know more detail about it, just tell me in the comments. The first and a very commonly implemented feature I added is coyote-time. We all know how it works, but basically the player has a couple of extra frames where they can jump after leaving the ground. You literally have no reason to not implement this. It's usually a few lines of code and makes the experience much better. Also, this shouldn't just be added to platformers only. FPS games can benefit from coyote time as well. The next feature I added is sort of the inverse of coyote time. Jump buffer is what I like calling it. Basically, if you press jump a little early before landing on the ground, the player will immediately jump when they touch the ground. This is a cool side effect where you can preserve your max speed for longer, as it only decreases when you are on the ground or when turning around. Doing chain jumps becomes much easier with this as well, which is something I'm going to talk about now. Boost jumps and chain jumps in Mount Major are done by switching sizes and jumping roughly at the same time. An example of this is a long jump, which you can do by switching to wide and jumping while moving in a direction. This gives a nice speed boost to the player. Doing it the other way around gives you a spring jump, which is just a large jump that's used for clearing large gaps and reaching high platforms. You can combine the two by doing a long jump directly into a spring jump to get a chain jump, which is an even more powerful spring jump. The last features are related to the timings of these boost jumps, as they would be frame perfect without them. First of all, there's a buffer where if you switch sizes early and then jump, it still works. Doing this the other way around is a bit more tricky, however. After you jump, there's a short window where you can switch sizes, but when you do, it adds the velocities of the boost jump you would have performed if you would have done it perfectly. This is a small issue where you can jump higher by intentionally delaying your size change, but it massively improves the casual player experience, so I still think it's worth it. Alright, now how does one implement all of this in code? Let's start with the first two, as they are both very similar. We're going to create two variables called coyote timer and jump buffer. When the player is on the floor, we will set coyote timer to some value, otherwise we take down the timer by that time. Now we can replace the ground check in the jump condition with our coyote timer, and that's the whole implementation of that feature. Don't forget to set the timer to 0 when you jump, otherwise you can do multiple jumps after each other. Now if the player leaves the ground, the timer will start ticking down, but as long as it's higher than 0, the player will still be able to jump. Super simple. Let's create the jump buffer now. It's going to start in a similar way. When the player presses the jump button, we will set the jump buffer variable to some amount, otherwise it will keep ticking down by that time. And now we do the exact same thing. Instead of checking if the player jumped at our jump condition, we check if jump buffer is higher than 0. And that's all the code for these two features. As you can see, it's super duper easy to implement, but it can have a huge impact on your movement system. Feature 3 and 4, the boost jump ones, are done similarly, so I'm not going to go through them. And those are specific implementations to my game, but you can probably imagine how they are done. So yeah, that's how you can improve your movement system with just a little effort. I could go into more mechanics like dashes and stuff, or how I implemented the boost jumps in my game, but I'm going to leave that for a future video. I'm going to start making some game design videos targeted for jammers starting in 2024 using the data I collect from GameOff, so subscribe if that sounds interesting to you. See ya!